Namaste everyone. In this video, we are going to learn about arithmetic progressions, that is, in short, it is called AP. Let us begin this session with an activity. A boy is participating in a race where he has to collect the balls placed on his track. He has to collect one ball at a time and return to the starting point, drop the ball, and then go for the next ball. We will see for each ball what distance he has to run. For the first ball, he starts, goes 6 meter, receives the ball and returns back 6 meter to the starting point. So for collecting the first ball, he has covered a distance of 12 meter. Similarly, he goes for the second ball, and this time he has to run 6 plus 2, 8 meter. And return to the starting point again 8 meter. So for the second ball, he has to run 16 meters. Next, he goes for the third ball. He runs 6 plus 2 plus 2, that is 10 meter, and 10 meter to return to the starting point. So total of 20 meters for third ball. Similarly, he goes for fourth, fifth and sixth ball. So for the last ball, he has covered a distance of 32 meter. We will be focusing on these numbers to study the arithmetic progression. Let us represent these numbers on a number line. The interesting thing about this set of numbers is that the difference between any two consecutive numbers is a fixed number, that is 4. In other words, if I am starting with a number 12, and if I want the next number in the list, I have to add 1 time 4. If I want the next number in the list, I have to add 2 times 4 to the first number 12. Similarly, if I want the next number, fourth number of the list, I have to add 3 times 4 to the first number 12. The next number is 4 times 4 added to 12. I think you must have guessed it correctly for the next number in the list. If I want 6th number, I have to add 5 times 4 to the first number 12. So you can see that whichever number I want starting from the first number, I have to add 1 time less the number, fixed number. Suppose if I generalize this, my first number or the first term is A, and each time I have to add a number D to get the next term, then my second term will be first term plus 1 time D. My third term will be first term A plus 2 times D. Similarly, my fourth number will be 3 times D added to the first number A. Fifth term will be 4 times D added to the first number A. Similarly, the sixth term will be A plus 5 times D. The list goes on in a similar pattern. Suppose if I want 28th term in the list, then what I have to add? Yes, I have to add 27 times D to the first term A. So in general, if I want any term, say for example nth term, then I have to add n minus 1 times D to the first number A. So a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term, except the first term, is called arithmetic progression. Here the fixed number is called common difference. So the general term of an arithmetic progression an is given by the formula a plus n minus 1d, where a is my starting number, that is the first term of the AP, which can be any real number. It may be positive, it may be negative, it can be rational, it can be irrational. Then d is the common difference which I am adding to get the next term. Again, d can be any real number. Then n is the number of terms in the given AP, that is the counting of the terms, so it can be any natural number. And an is the nth term of the given AP. For example, 6th term, then it will be a6. 7th term, then it will be a7. 28th term, then it will be a28, and so on. Thank you for learning.